This is a pill. This is a doctor who prescribed it. And this is a patient who needs it for the health and well-being. But from where did the pill come from? Who and what did it take to create it? Behind every pill, there are lots of people who dedicate their lives to make us better by discovering new medicines through research, which involves complex journey of research, technology, funding, and ethics. A pathway of how drug is made is shown. It starts with finding the target, followed by identifying the hit compounds, doing preclinical studies, taking approval, and performing clinical trials before releasing it into the market. Of this, we will be focusing on clinical trials in this video, and stick till the end of the video for the bonus tip.
Press the bell icon and never miss an update from Pharma Knowledge.
Clinical trials are the research studies that evaluate new ways to improve treatments and quality of life for people with diseases. Clinical trials are an option for all people to consider and play an important role in improving healthcare. These help in development of new drugs, new diagnostic tools or devices, or new clinical procedures. All the drugs and tools we have today were made possible because patients volunteered for a clinical trial. All clinical trials have an eligibility and exclusion criteria. Example, certain medical condition or gender is required for participating in the trial. Otherwise, they are not eligible to join the trial. There are various benefits and risks associated with participating in the trial. The volunteer must check before participating. Benefits include receive new treatments, close inspection from clinical staff. Sometimes the cost of the treatment is free or waived off, and helping healthcare system to develop treatment for the future patients. The risks include the treatment may not be beneficial. Patients need commitment, that is, trials can be lengthy, time and money consuming. And in case of randomized or blind studies, the patients might not receive the new treatment. Informed consent is one of the critical steps. It is the process in which a healthcare provider educates a patient about the risks, benefits, and alternatives of a given procedure or intervention. The patient must be competent to make a voluntary decision whether to undergo the procedure or not. This became important after the infamous doctor's trial. Nazi human experimentation was a series of medical experiments on large number of prisoners, including children, by Nazi Germany in its concentration camps in early to mid 1940s during World War II and Holocaust. Nazi physicians and their assistants forced prisoners into participation where they did not willingly volunteer and no consent was given for the procedure. Typically, the experiments resulted in death, trauma, or permanent disability, and as such are considered examples of medical torture. After the war, these crimes were addressed, which became to known as Doctor's Trial, and this led to the development of Nuremberg's Code of Medical Ethics. Before we start with the actual phases, you should be familiar with few terms. Randomized controlled trial. A randomized controlled trial is a type of scientific experiment that aims to reduce certain sources of bias when testing the effectiveness of the new treatment. Randomization means the process of randomly allocating subjects to two or more groups, treating them differently. Control means comparing one group with respect to the measured response. Example, in a control study, the first group receives the standard drug and a new drug, that is, this is a treatment group, and the second group receives only a standard drug or a placebo, it is a control group. And then the first group is compared with the second to test the effectiveness of the new treatment by reducing the bias. There is another term, blinding studies. It is a process in which one or more parties in a trial are kept unaware of which treatment is provided. It helps in eliminating bias. In case of single blinded study, the patients are kept unaware of which drug is administered. in case of double blinded studies, both doctors and patients are unaware of the treatment, while in case of the triple blinded studies, even the statisticians are unaware of this treatment. So let's jump to phases. There are four phases in a clinical trial. In all phases, the safety is utmost important. If in any phase there are any issues, then the trial will not be allowed to proceed further in the phase. Before starting the clinical trials, the researchers or the sponsors must submit IND, that is Investigational New Drug Application, to the regulatory health authorities like FDA in US, CDSCO as in India. This application includes data obtained from preclinical studies and lab studies. Trials can start once approval is granted by the authorities. Phase 1. It is also called as a pharmacological phase, as it involves studies about pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamic parameters of the drug. In simple words, it involves studies regarding how drug moves throughout the body and body's response towards it. The main difference from the other phases is it involves healthy volunteers, which are the unit of study. And the aim is to determine the maximum tolerated drug dose. It may long from 6 months to 12 months and includes about 30 to 50 subjects. The success rate is about 70%. There is another phase which is not mandatory. It is called as phase 0. It is also called as a human microdose study. It is done before phase 1, where low dose is given to the subjects and the aim is to get pharmacokinetic parameters. It involves about 10 to 15 subjects. Phase 2. It is also called as the exploratory phase, as it explores the safety and efficacy of the drug. The eligibility of the criteria is more restricted. The trials can be randomized or non-randomized, and it may last from several months to years. The phase 2 is divided into 2A, which is specifically designed to study the dosing requirement, that is, how much drug should be given, and 2B, specifically designed to study the efficacy, that is, how well the drug works at the prescribed dose. It involves 80 to 200 subjects, and the success rate is about 33%. Phase 3. It is also called as a confirmatory phase, as it confirms the safety and efficacy of the drug. It is conducted in even larger groups. It involves randomized design, where new treatment is compared with the standard treatment, that is a randomized controlled trial. Questions like, how does it work on larger population? How is it better than other treatment are answered. And the purpose of the phase of the study is to find efficacy and monitor the adverse drug reaction. It involves about 300 to 3000 subjects and needs years to complete. The success rate is about 25 to 30%. The next is NDA filing. The researchers or the sponsors must submit NDA, that is New Drug Application, to the health authorities. This document is request to approve the investigational product. There are authorities check each and every data generated from each phase, and if they find it satisfactory, the drug is approved for the launch. There are other types of application, example ANDA, that is abbreviated New Drug Application, for biosimilar or generic drugs, which does not require conduction of clinical trials. Instead, they must scientifically demonstrate that the product is bioequivalent, that is, performs in the same manner as that of the main drug by suitable means. The final phase is a phase 4. It is also called as post-marketing phase, as it occurs after the approval of the drug in the market. It is a practice of continued monitoring to assess the safety, effectiveness and optimal use after it has been released into the market. It helps to understand rare and long-term adverse effects. The success rate is about 70 to 90%. Clinical trials play an important role in moving science forward and can be an hopeful option for many patients. To learn more about clinical trials, talk to your doctor and visit clinicaltrials.gov website. Here's a bonus. These are the few terms you need to know and be prepared for the pharmacovigilance type of interviews. Find a link to the document in the description below.